A very large fraction of the districts in the United States are very small districts, some of them as small as a single school. Now, our next district, our next showcase district is La Grande Elementary in the Central Valley in California, and our good friend Scott Borba. Scott, great to see you. Thank you very much. Tell us what you could possibly pull off in a one school district in the Valley in California.
Well, thanks, John. I almost feel like, is this the right conference for my little 350 student school? Hi, my name is Scott Borba. I'm the proud superintendent principal of the Grand Union Elementary School District in the heart of California. Here's a little picture of my school. We are a 100% agriculturally surrounded school. We farm almonds and tomatoes and everything else. And so when I came to La Grande 5 years ago, I asked my fifth graders, what do you want to be when you grow up? And out of all that information, this is what I got in 2018. About 5% of them wanted to work in a field that was related to computer science. Now, I don't have a degree in computer science. I just recognize that it's a passion that opens up opportunities for our scholars in their future. And so over the last 5 years, through integrating computer science onto my campus in various forms, which I'll talk about in my next 3 minutes, you can see this past fall, almost 45% of my students now want to grow up and work in the field of computer science. Back in 2018, guess what those four students said? I want to design video games. Now in 2022, I have, of course, I still have my video game designers, but I also have computer programmers, artificial intelligence and robotic engineers, and even astronauts. So I'm pretty excited about where our students are starting to dream. This is a picture from a weather balloon my scholars launched in conjunction with Stanford University. If I had 20 more minutes, I could tell you about this great story of how we connected with Stanford. But we launched a weather balloon that reached almost 70,000 feet. We put a little $100 GoPro, generic GoPro camera on it, and you could see our little Lego figurine out on the end. But that's 70,000 feet above our community. My school, my guys, we're a small school, but we have huge dreams out in La Grande. And just some demographics. So we are 90% free and reduced lunch where we are, 45% second language learners. And look what they saw. When we recovered our payload, we were able to download these photos. So they are big dreamers. Here's my first ever La Grande Student Space Initiative team. We launched this balloon from Hollister, and it sailed out over the Pacific Ocean. This was our second payload that we launched that year. And you can see we even have a Pringles can on the side of it. We had to go to our local mom and pop store to get all the supplies. One of the things that we love to do, of course, is the Hour of Code and Family Code Night. That's something we do every year at La Grande. And it just gets our families engaged and excited about coding. You can see one of my scholars here. This is a picture says 1,000 words. They're excited. Finally, of course, the first Lego League. And I heard our friends from Putnam County talking about the first Lego League. And this is a huge, huge program at our school where our scholars get to design, build, engineer, and program Lego robots that they get to then compete in local competitions. I'm the only district in my entire county that does this. So we have to travel to neighboring counties to compete. And I'm proud to say that this year that our robot right there, the one you can see in the bottom left corner, won first place in robot design. Very proud of my scholars. So what am I here to tell you? You might be intimidated about getting computer science started in your school. And I can't say anything but just do it. Just start. I don't have a staff for this. I don't have a budget for this. I spend maybe, I don't know, $800 a year on Legos and the new kit and the new game. And just start, just go and get your scholars excited. They want this. They love Scratch coding. They love taking it to the next level. And now we have Scratch coders in all grade levels. And through a partnership with Acelus, we actually have coding going on starting in third grade all the way through eighth grade, where my eighth graders are starting to leave learning Java. And then they're moving into the high school. My poor high school superintendent says, Scott, I'm not ready for them yet. And so she has to build CTE pathways in computer science just to get ready for my kids. And that's it. That's all I have to say.
That's all you need to say. Thank you so much. I still remember in our first conversation, and maybe this isn't the right way to put it, but when you said that a lot of your kids hadn't been across the I-5 to the other Taco Bell in town, I mean, that you can take, have that kind of impact in your community. It's such a tribute to your leadership. We really appreciate it.